Hey everyone, what's up? It's Rob Dodson here, and in this episode, I'm going to show you how you can beef up your core icons by loading in additional icon sets. I'm also going to show you how you can create your own custom icon sets using SVG. So let's check it out. Okay, so we're going to start by building our own icon set from scratch. That'll show off all the concepts that we want to cover in this video. So we're going to be using the core icon set SVG element. Now keep in mind, there's also a core icon set element that's primarily for generating raster icon sets. We're going to focus on the SVG version because it looks nicer and tends to scale better on different screens. Now, this is the first icon that we're going to be producing, and we're going to give it the name Fancy Circles. And, you know, it's not actually that fancy, it's just a few overlapping circles, but it'll be a good starting point for our icon set. And the first thing we got to do is we need to import the definition for our core icon set SVG element. So over here, I've got Bower Components, core icon set SVG. And that's going to actually load in this tag over here so I can start using it in my application. And the next thing I want to do is I want to configure this thing. So I got to give it an ID. And this ID is really important because this is actually the name of my icon set, right? This is how people are going to refer to my icon set later on when they want to pull something out of it. So we're calling it custom icons. And if we want, we can also give it an optional icon size. Here I'm setting it to 50, which means 50 pixels. By default, all the icons coming out of our set would be 24 pixels. But setting this icon size is going to boost that up for us. Again, it's optional. You don't have to include it if you don't want to. Now I'm going to open my icon set tag up. And I'm going to drop some SVG markup inside of here. And this is actually the SVG code that's going to generate those circles for us. And the thing to note here is that we also need to give this an ID. And this is actually the name of our icon. So when someone wants to use this icon, they're going to ask for the icon set. And then they're going to ask for the icon. I'll show you an example of that. So here I've got a core icon element. The icon attribute's totally empty. So we're going to ask for the icon set, which was custom icons. We'll ask for the icon, which is fancy circles. We'll separate them with a little colon. And now our icon is showing up on screen. But it doesn't quite look like what we imagined, right? It's all one color, so it's kind of boring. But this is actually one of the cooler aspects of SVG. Because under the hood, everything is markup, we can actually go in and target the different SVG elements and style them individually. So let me show you how that works. So here's my icon over here, and I've got a style element on the left. And what I'm going to do is start writing selectors to target the bits of the icon that I want to colorize. So I'll start with this top circle and kind of move my way down all the way to the bottom, right? So I can go in and style the individual parts if I want. If you remember in the last video, we showed how you can use the color property to give an icon like a uniform color all the way across. You can still do that with this icon if you want, but SVG kind of allows you a little bit more control if you need it, which is pretty cool. All right, so now you've gone ahead, you've made your first icon set. You know how all that works. Next thing I want to do is I want to take somebody else's icon set and load it into my project. Now, if you recall in the last video, I showed you this link, right, which goes to the documentation for the core icon default icon set. But if you scroll around that page, you'll see that there's actually a whole bunch of other stuff on here, right? There's other icon sets. There's AV icons for audiovisual, maps, hardware, right? So if you want to load an icon from one of those sets, the cool thing is that it works exactly the same way as the custom icon set we were just showing. So I'll give you an example here. Let's say I want to load in this play icon from the AV icon set. So I'm going to import the definition for those icons. So I'm going to ask for core icons, AV icons. And then I can just use the AV icon in my core icon element. So I'm going to say I want a AV icon, colon, play arrow. And that's going to give me this icon right over here. Super simple. All right, so now you know how to create your own icon set. You know how to take an icon set that somebody else has made for you and actually load it into your project. Let's switch over to our code editor now, and we're actually going to get some of this showing up on screen. All right, so here we've got a project that's all set up and ready to go. And the first thing we're going to want to do is create a brand new file called customicons.html. And this is actually where we're going to put the definition for the icon that we write. Now that we've got this file ready, we can just import the definition for the core icon set SVG element. So I'm assuming it's in Bower Components, and I pull in core icon set SVG. And now that that's ready, I can actually just use the icon set tag on my page. So core icon set SVG. And we're going to configure it. We're going to make sure to give it the ID. So our icon set has a name. So we're going to call it custom icons. And we'll also throw in the icon size attribute as well. And we'll set it equal to 50. Now remember, this icon size attribute is optional. You don't have to include it. I'm just throwing it in here for, you know, for funsies, so you guys can see it. OK, so I'm just going to go down and actually paste in the code, the SVG code for my icon. And you'll see here that I've got that ID. So my icon has a name of fancy circles. And at this point, my icon set is basically complete, right? It's an icon set of one, right? There's only one icon in it, but that's cool. We'll see what we can get showing up. So over in my index file, there's a few things I got to do. I got to make sure to pull in the platform. So I'm going to pull in Bower Components, platform, platform.js. I'm going to import in the definition for the core icon element so I can actually display my icon. And I'm going to import the definition for this custom icons file that I just created, right? So now my icon set is available. And down in my body tag, I'll just throw in a core icon. And I'm going to set the icon attribute equal to custom icons and put a colon in there, and then fancy circles. Now, if I save this, hop over to my browser and refresh the page, up there in the corner, you'll see a little icon. And I'm going to boost this up so you can see it a bit easier. There's our fancy circles kind of ready to go. Now, if you recall, we got to go in and we got to add some style to it so it looks like we expect. So I'm going to add a style element. And again, I'm just going to paste in the CSS here so you guys don't have to watch me type it all out. All right, now that's in. And I'm just going to clean up the formatting a little bit. So we save this, refresh the page, and now our icon's showing up as we expect it. Now, what's really cool is, you know, we can go in and we can change these fill colors to whatever we want, right? So we can set this equal to like red, green, blue. And it's not going to be the best looking icon, but it will sort of demonstrate the point that we really can go in and target different parts of our icon and change the appearance, which is really handy. OK, so I've shown you how to load in your custom icon. Let's go back and clean that up a little. OK. Now let's actually load an icon from one of the additional sets that come with the core icons package. So I'm going to, up here in my imports area, I'm going to import the definition for the AV icon set. So I'm assuming it's in Bower Components. I'm going to ask for core icons slash av-icons.html. If you want, if you actually open your Bower Components folder and open the core icons package, you can see all the different icon sets that are in here. So there's like AV icons, communication, device, hardware, lots of cool stuff in there to play around with. And it's really as easy as just importing the definition. So down here in my body tag, I'm going to add another core icon. And this time, I'm going to set the icon attribute equal to AV colon play arrow. And that's going to give me the play arrow from the AV set. Right, refresh my page, and now I've got this black icon up here. If I want to style it, right, and give it some color, I can, you know, maybe give it like a class name or something like that. So I'll say the class is equal to icon play. And then in my CSS, I'll just style off of that class and say, hey, icon play should have a color of like light green or something, just to show that you can go in and you can style, you know, an entire icon one color. Cool, awesome. Now, one thing that's really neat, which we haven't touched on before, is to point out the fact that, you know, there's a bunch of different elements in the core element set that support icon attributes. So I'm actually going to import the definition for a core icon button. This is something that we haven't actually seen yet, but it's really handy. So I'll pull in a core icon button. And then I'm just going to use its icon attribute to load in one of these AV icons. So I'm asking for a core icon button. I'm going to set its icon equal to AV colon play arrow. Swap back over to the browser, refresh the page. And if I sort of adjust the size down on our browser window, now we've got this really cool play button. Super simple. All right, so you're now officially a core icon master. You know how to create icon sets. You know how to load in icon sets that other people have made for you. And you know how to style all of it using CSS. That means it's your turn to go out there and to start creating something really awesome. Thanks for watching.